In this class, we are going to be discussing estimate types and how to enter in estimates. So let's navigate to the jobs menu. Head over to setup, job estimate types. Okay, so the system comes with some estimate types already set up. So to explain these a little bit, your original estimate is going to include the original workflow type, which would be like your original bid, okay? The approved change workflow type or transaction type, you could think of it, is our change orders. Your revision would be if you wanted to make some budget or estimate modifications. And then the forecast would be if you wanted to use estimates in this here, for example, this one, to forecast out to completion to the end of the job. Okay. So the system will track your original estimate, your original bid. It'll track your current estimate, which is mainly what you're going to be using in the system. That includes your change orders and any revisions you make to the original. So you can set up more if you'd like. More estimate types, but these would be ones to start with, okay? So to add an estimate type, it's really easy. You just hit the add button at the top right, give it a name. Maybe you want and we want to include the original estimate and maybe this other category you can use for buyout savings that you've made or buyout reductions, okay? So now I have an original estimate that's just going to include my original budget items that I put into the system, and then I have this new one. That's original budget, and then maybe I've made some savings when I bought out the job, which we could put to that, this other category. So this should work for how many you need. If you need more than this, you might want to talk about that with your team, but this should cover quite a bit of what you need for an estimate type. You don't want to have like tens of hundreds in here, or you don't want to have too many in here, okay? All right, so now let's navigate over to an estimate, and we'll show you how to enter in an estimate. Okay, so let's say you are entering in an estimate manually. So you would hit the add button up here. I'm gonna pick a job. And let's name the estimate something like that. Notice my estimate ID says new, which will mean the system is going to automatically assign an estimate number. Since you associate the estimate with the job, the estimate number doesn't make too much difference. But if you would like that turned off and you would like to number your estimates similar to your job numbers, then you can do that in your configuration settings and turn off the document, the auto sequencing for estimates. Okay. So we're going to call this the original estimate. And my estimate date pre-filled in because I put that date on my project setup. So when I set this project up, that was on there. Okay. Now the primary box will check automatically when you put the first estimate into the system. So don't get confused by that. After I save this, it will mark this one as the primary because this is the first one. You can mark it yourself as well. Okay, so here's some read-only information from the job setup. And then down here, you're going to come down here. And pick original. So this is the original budget information. And pick a cost code. And pick a cost type. It automatically pre-fills the item in for you, so leave that the way it is. We're just going to come over here and put an amount in. And you can obviously use these fields to calc the amount. But. And then you can hit save. And you keep adding lines. So this next line, you add original. Keep adding lines down as wanted. Okay. So now you can see that once I save this, the primary checkbox is now showing. So if I go back in and edit this, I did not check that, but the system automatically did it. Okay. Now, obviously, you see the duplicate button up here. You can duplicate this estimate. Name it something different and make some changes to it if you like. So you can easily duplicate estimates up here. Okay, so now let's say we, instead of manually entering in a budget, we want to import one in. So you can see the import functionality up here. So the import estimate only means a job is already set up in the system, in the project setup. The job setup. This one here will bring in the estimate and will bring in the job and set up the job as well. Now there's only some basic information it'll set up on the job, but it will allow you to do that all in one step. You could then always navigate over to the job setup screen and fill in more information on the job. Okay, so in order to get to these import templates, you need to navigate to the company import data area. And scroll down to the import estimate only or import estimate with work breakdown structure and click on the template button. Okay, so if I do that, you'll see I get an Excel file. And the Excel file will give you some headers and some information that you can fill in. Okay, so as an example, I've got one filled out already with a few lines. Pull that up. And you can see this file has the top header row corresponding with this top header row. So let me scroll over on this one so you can see. Intacct. Let me go over to the estimate area. Now, I already have one that I've brought in, so I want to get rid of this one before we bring it in again as an example. So I'm going to get rid of this primary checkbox first. Otherwise, I cannot delete it. Okay, so you want to uncheck that, save it. And then we're going to delete it. Okay, so now that is gone. So we want to bring in that estimate that I have saved. And just a tidbit, if you don't do that, take the primary off, it won't let you delete it. So, okay. And we're going to leave everything else the same here. It's a large estimate. You could process it offline, so it does it in a scheduled batch later in the day. But you can just leave all this the way it is. I'm going to hit import. And my job imported successfully, so I'm going to hit done. I'm going to refresh my screen. And now you can see that estimate that was brought in. Now let's look at the template that is called Import Estimate with Work Breakdown Structure. So this button right here, this is the one that will bring in the project with the estimate and set up some base fields and set up the project for you. So the differences from the import estimate only and this one here are highlighted in yellow. So you will need to give it a project name. You need to give it beginning date, the end date, location, category, etc. So these yellow fields are the differences between the import estimate only and the import estimate with WBS or work breakdown structure. So just to point out the differences there, they're in these highlighted columns. So a lot of the time you might have an outside software and you're going to bring in your job when your estimate's complete. This would be a good example to use this template. Some systems are integrated with Sage Intacct, and you don't even need to do this import functionality or bring in a manual job estimate. You're going to have an integration going on. But this would be how to bring in an estimate from a system that's not integrated or manually in Excel. And that is the class on how to revise or put in job estimate types and how to enter in or import in job estimates.